Welcome everyone to today class. Today we are here to learn number of zeros in any product or any factorial number. I'm trying to cover all types of this question of number system in one particular video without any multiplication, just with shortcut and involving all the methods which you will be able to crack any question. Let's start with. So what is the number of trailing zeros in 12,000? See, when you have 12,000, that means trailing zeros, what is the meaning of this? That how many zeros will occur consecutively in the last of the number. So you can, without doing anything, you can say 3. Just see the logic behind it. So we'll try to factorize this, right? So it will be 10. 1200, then 10, 120, 10, 12, 2, 6, 2, 3, and 3, 1. So see how many 5s are there? 5 to the power 3. How many 2s? 3 here, 4, 5, and 1, 3. So zeros can always come when there will be 5 and there will be 2. So that means if the number of 5s will be less, that means our trailing zeros will be less. So number of zeros will be 3 here. So that means in every question, we are going to factorize it and going to find how many pairs of 5 and 2. Basically, you will see the number of 5 would be less. So we'll prefer finding the 5 factors. Let's start with the next question. Hope you are understanding it and enjoying it. Now go to the next question. So 625 times 64. So we are trying to find the factors of it. You can use the tree method for this. You can use the ladder method. Whatever you prefer, you use it. So 5 to the power 4 times 62. 64 is how much? 2 to the 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. So 2 to the power 6. Which is less? 4 is less. So number of trailing zeros will be 4. Whichever will be less will be the answer. Always generally 5 will be less. So number of trailing zeros is 4 because 5 to the power 4. So number of trailing zeros will be 4. Now you see this question. How many zeros in 25 times, 20 times, 35 times, 42 times 65. So here we are going to find factors of 5. So how much? 5 square. Here 5 times 4. So 5 into 2 square. See, 4 into 5, 20. Here 5 times 7. We are not concerned about 7. Here 2. So 2 into 21. So we are not concerned about 21. And then 5 and 13. So see, how many powers of 5? 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 to the power 5. How many powers of 2? 2 to the power 3. So whichever less will be number of zeros. So number of trailing zeros, trailing, we use the word trailing zero, will be how much? 3. So that's how we are going to attempt this type of question. Now, find the number of zeros in 2 to the power 145 into 5 to the power 234. This look relatively tough, but I tell you, this is the most easiest one which we have done. 2 to the power 145 into 5 to the power 234, which is less? 2 power and 5 power, what is the less power? 145. So number of trailing zeros is equal to 145. Trailing zeros means what? Suppose 2, 0, 0, 0, 0. So after the number, how many consecutive zeros? These are called the trailing zeros. So here it is 4. So that is the concept of trailing zeros. Always the exam, they ask this type of question. Now see this question. Find the number of zeros in this same question. So see, 150. So 150 has how many zeros? 150, if you factorize, then 5 and 30, then 5 and 6, 2 and 3. So we are concerned about only 5 and 2s. So we write 20. So 20 is 2 square into 5. So we write into 5 into 2 square. 13, no. 75, 15 into 5. So 15 into 5. So definitely we have 2, 5 here. 60 is 12 into 5. So 1, 5 here for 60 and 12, 4. So 2 square. And here 5, 1 and 2, 1. So add all the powers. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5 to the power 7. Here 4, 5, 6. What is less? Power of 2 is less. So number of zeros will be 6. That's how we have to attempt. Now see, number of zeros in 69. So when you have 69, this is talking about factorial. Just for simple, I tell you what is the meaning of factorial. Like factorial 5 means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Factorial 10 means 10 times 9 into 8 till continue to 1. This is the meaning of factorial. We also write this in this form. These are the two notations of writing factorial. So this is another, yes, very, very common question in Olympiad. And this is very easy to solve. Just see how we can solve this very easily. What we are going to do, we are going to divide it by 5. So 13 times 5, 65, 13. Now see, this is bigger than 5. So you divide one more time by 25. We are going to divide by powers of 5. Okay, so 5 here, 25. So 69 divided by 25, 2, because 3 times will be 75. So how many zeros will be? 13 plus 2, 15. Because since this number is less than 5, so no need to divide further. So number of zeros in 69 factorial is 15. Understand everything? Now, when you have 2, 2, 2, 2. So what we can do? 2, 2, 2 divided by 5. 2, 2, 2 divided by 25. Then 2, 2, 2 divided by 125. Now next power of 5 is 625. This is bigger, so we can't divide. So 2, 2, 2 divided by 5 is how much? 44. This one is how much? 2, 2, 2 divided by 25 is how much? 8. And here it is 1. Because 125 times 2 will be 250, will be more. So this will be 44 plus 9. So this will be 53. That means we have 53 number of zeros in this. Understood, everyone? So these are some fun facts about numbers from 1 to 10. So let's have a look. 0 is the additive identity. 1 is the multiplicative identity. 2 is the only number which is even, but it is prime. 3 is the number of spatial dimension we live in. Like this, we have taken all the fun facts of number from 1 to 10. In next video, I'll try to give you next one. So let's start with the next. So here, fun facts about numbers from 1 to 10 is being discussed. So these are, you can just study it. Let's try another. Number of zeros in 247 times 45. So just see this one. Same way, we'll approach the problem same way. So 257 factorial times 45 factorial. Individually attempted, 257 divided by 5, 257 divided by 25, and 257 divided by 125. Next will be 625, we'll not take it. So here it will be how much? 51. Here it will be how much? 10. Here it will be 2. So how much you got? 51, 61, 63. Right? Now in 45, just see. 45 will be how much? 45 divided by 5. 45 divided by 25. Next 125 will be bigger. We don't take it. So 9 here and 1 here. So 10. So So total will be how much? 63 times 10. That will be 630. That would be the answer. Now same way. So we have to find number of zeros in 12 factorial times 18 factorial times 5. So first we'll find in 12 factorial. So 12 divided by 5. We don't need to do further. Okay, so here you got 2. Now 18 factorial. So again only 18 divided by 5. So you got 3. Okay, so what we are going to do now? So here you see 5 times 2, 10. So only 2. Because we cannot divide by here 25. Similarly, here it will come 3 and here it will come 1. So we'll have 6 number of trailing zeros in the above factorial where it is given in the product form. Let's take another example here. When it is given like suppose it is given 127 factorial times 57 factorial. So what we do, 127 divided by 5 plus 127 divided by 25 plus 127 divided by 125. This is for this part, right? Left part. And here 57 divided by 5 plus 57 factorial divided by 25. We will not go further because 125 will be bigger. So here how much it will come? 25 times 25. So 25 here, then 25 times 5 and here 1. So total 31, right? Here it will be 11 and here it will be 2. So 13. So total how much? 44. So whenever it will be product factorial, so you have to remember that you have to multiply. Ultimately, it will be multiply only, so that you have to take care. Let's go to next part. So here, when you have 255 factorial, so the method remains the same. 255 divided by 5, 255 divided by 25, 255 divided by 125, and we will not do further because it will be 625. So here it will be 51, here it will be 10, and 255 divided by 125 will be 2. So we will got 63, and that would be our answer. Let's go to next question. So when you have 123, the case is same, 123 divided by 5, 123 divided by 25, and 123 divided by 125 will not take this because this will be smaller. So 123 divided by 5 will be 25 times 5, so 24. And here 25 times 5, so 4. So a total will be 28. And that would give us the... Now you see, when you have 1123, so 1123 divided by 5, 1123 divided by 25, 1123 divided by 125, and 1123 divided by 625. Later it will be 3125, that will be bigger. So here it will be 224, then here 25 times 5, 25 times 4, 144, and here it will be 8, and here it will be 1. So 8 times plus 1, 9, here 53, so 224 times 53 give you 277, and that would be our answer. Now see, if you try to take here common, so 5 is common in how much? Till 250. So 250 divided by 5 gives you how much? 550. That means 5 to the power 50. So that will give you 1 into 2 into 3 times till 50. So 1, 2, 3 times factorial 50 will give you how much? Factorial 50. Up to this step is clear. What we have done? 5 to the power 50 into factorial 50. Now, what we will do? Now here we see number of power of 5 is 5 to the power 50. So definitely here power of 2 will be less. So we'll try to find the power of 2 here. So power of 2 in factorial 50. So 50 divided by 2 plus 50 divided by 4 plus 50 divided by 8 plus 50 divided by 16 plus 50 divided by 32, and next will not come. So here it will come 25, 50 divided by 4, 12. Then here 50 divided by 8 will be 6 and 3 and 1.5, so 1. Like that you have to do. Like 50 divided by 2, 25, 25 half, 12, then 12 half, 12 means 12.5, so we consider 12 because remainder will not take, and then 6 and then 3 and then this. So how much will be when adding, how much it will be? 6, 3, 9, 10, so 22, so 47. Now you see the power of 2 is 47 and power of 5 is how much? 50. Which is less? 2 is less, because power of 5, like 247 into 547 will give much, how much? 1047. So that means trailing zeros will be 47 and 5 to the power 3 will be left behind. So that means the number of trailing zeros will be defined by 247, because 550 is greater. So answer will be 47 here. This was a very exception case, so I discuss it in full. Let's try another example. Now see, we have understood till now that 2 into 5 always gives us 10. So first we have to find how many 2s here and how many 5s here. So if you see 1 into 2 into 3 into 99 into 100, so the first set of 5 is 5, 10, continue till 100. So 100 divided by 5, 20. Right? So 5 is 20. Now, next, second set of 5. What it will be? 25, 50, 75, 100. So 1, 1, it will be how much? 5 to the power 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 in all. Right? So here it is 24. So definitely 2s will be more. We'll not count 2s. Any product when we have like 2, then 2 is always more. So no need of calculating for 2s. So first we'll calculate first set of 5. We consider 5, 10, 15, 20. So arithmetic series, no? 5, let me explain you. 5, 10, 15, 20 till 100. So this is a AP series. So we can say there will be 20 terms, right? First we consider that. Now next set of 5 is what? Where there are 2 5, like 25, right? And then 50. So in 50, we have included here 50, but because 25 has one more, similarly, it means actually we are saying that we are considering the multiples of 25, because 25 has 5 2 times. So here are total 5. So 20 plus 24 means 25 has 2 5s. No, similarly 50 has 2 5, which is not accounted here. We have counted only twice. So that's how we added more 4 extras. So that I meant to say here. Let's try to solve this question. First we'll try to understand a basic, like suppose we have 10 plus 100 plus 1000 plus 10,000. We have to find how much will be the number of zeros in the end. If we take 10 common, so 1 plus 10 plus 100 plus 1000. So see, this will have 1 at the end. So how many zeros are there? Only 10. So if you understand this concept that the term present inside the bracket has unit digit 1, right? So which when multiplied by 10 result only in 1 zero. So that means if we find what is the maximum number here, just see. So here, how many number of zeros are there? So whichever is having less number of 5 and 2s will do our job. Here, power is how much? 2 power 11 and 5 power at least 9, correct? 5 to the power 3, 9. Now here you see 2 to the power 10, 5 to the power only 1. And here 5 to the power 125. So directly you can see the number of zeros in the expression will be only 1. See, very, very easily just by observation you can solve this question. Now in this expression, we are again going to search for 5. We are not going to hunt for 2 because 2 will be definitely more. So 5 will be less. So see, how will you count? 5 to the power 5. Okay. And then 10 to the power 10. Then 15 to the power 15. Correct? So that means 5 to the power will have how many powers? 5. This one will have 10. This one will have 15. Continue till 100 will have 100. So if you see this, take 5 common. So 1 plus 2 plus this dot 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 till 20. So that means if you take the AP series, so 5 into n, n plus 1 by 2, right? So how much it give you? 1050. But you can assume that there is one mistake. What mistake is there? We have assumed that 25, 25 will give 25 fives, but it will not. It will give you 50s. Similarly, 50, 50 will give me 100 fives, right? 100 fives. Similarly, 75, 75 will give you 150 fives. And 100, 100 will give you 200 fives. So total will be how much? How much error we have made? 25 plus 50 plus 75 plus 100. So because we have counted half up, so that will be how much error? 255s. So our answer will be how much? 1050 plus 250, that will be 1300. So total number of trailing zeros will be 1300 here. This was, I have considered the all the toughest possible question in this chapter. Now this is a question where finding out n when number of trailing zeros in n. Just this is just opposite of the case, right? So what we can do here, see, let's consider that we'll take, there is no standard formula for this, but we have to try heat and trial. Let's try 65 factorial. So 65 divided by 5, 65 divided by 25, and later on will not do. So here it will get 13, and definitely here more, so 15. So we'll take a lesser power, let's try 60. So 60 divided by 5 plus 60 divided by 25, so here it will be 12, and here it will be 2, so 14. Another less, let's try 55. So 55 divided by 5 plus 55 divided by 25, so here it will be 11 plus 25, 2, so 13. So just see, the answer will be 55 factorial. So number of trailing zeros in n factorial is 13. So then what we can do, that n will be factorial 55. That's how you can find the answer very, very easily. Now a trend is that they are reversing the question. Earlier they were finding the trailing number of zeros. Now in most of the competitions, they are not asking you trailing number of zeros, but opposite of them, that how much will be the factorial if the number of trailing zeros is given. Now another question in this regard, we'll just check. So let's assume we will take 100 factorial. So suppose we have take 100 factorial. So 100 divided by 5, 100 divided by 25, and later on we don't need. So here 20 and 4, so 23. Let's take lesser. So we take 95. So 95 divided by 5 and 95 divided by 25. So here you got 90 plus 3, 22. So see, here you got 24, sorry, this was high. And here you got 22, that is low. So that means number of zeros in factorial n, so n is not possible. Or we can say, there is no valid value of n for which factorial n will have 23 zeros in the end. That is the case here. So it will be not defined. None of the such valid n factorial numbers are possible. That we need to say here. Thank you. Take care. Stay safe. Bye bye.